Jag är T-Rex.
Alex is finally asleep and I thought I'd try to get some workout in before he wakes up. The days when I can't make it to the gym, I want to at least try to make a couple of push-ups and the plank here at home so I do get some exercise, because enough is enough. I really need to get back in some sort of shape. Gotta multitask between the sets. There we go. There's only so much you can do in that short period of time when your kid is sleeping. Stay-at-home dad at the same time as you're trying to make YouTube videos. Not saying that it's the best combo ever, but it's also a fun way to document my life. You know, I've been using the A7S III now for almost 9 months, and if you remember a while back, I did have an issue with the screen like coming loose in the hinge. This shouldn't happen to a $5,500 camera. I haven't been putting it through anything weird, but the screen has come loose. The screen isn't broken or anything like that, but it does make you not want to use it as much as you should be, because now every time I touch it, I think that I'm gonna break it. And I did send off that camera to repair. Sony fixed it. They were super cool about it. And I thought that that was it, but see that? That is actually a pretty big, I don't know how you say it in English, but in Swedish you say glapp. The first time I would pass it off as some sort of like bad example that I got, but now that has happened a second time, I actually start to think that it's something wrong with the screen. And since I'm shooting this on an A7S III as well, I'm a little bit worried that this will happen to this screen too, but I'm not entirely sure yet if it's gonna be an issue or if it's like gonna be fixed on the warranty, because I don't want to have my screen flapping around like this, especially not after such a short period of time, because it's an expensive camera, so it should hold up. I know that a lot of you has been missing this, but check this out. Podcast with Tom, podcast with Tom, podcast with Tom, podcast with Tom. The podcast is coming back. Swedish fika. Cleaning is one of the things that I do not like to do, and that is why I want to make it as easy as possible to clean quickly. And being able to have easy access to all down, back up again, ta-da! That's pretty cool. It is currently 20:45, and it's a Friday night and I'm here at the studio because I have a huge
business meeting today that is going to be extremely fun. Can't tell you that much about it, unfortunately, but it's going to be connected with the thing that I had yesterday. So you're going to have to figure things out. And I kind of want to talk a little bit about the goals that I have, both personally, but also from the business aspect and where I see myself in a couple of years from now. Because ever since I started this whole YouTube journey, everything has been kind of a blur. I haven't really been able to take the time and, you know, sit back, relax, think about my future and what I want to do and all of those things. And one thing for certain, I really, really want to keep doing YouTube because I love doing this. The second thing is that I also want to keep doing videos and photos and be creative in the ways that I feel that I get something out from. And I think that YouTube is a fantastic way to do that, as well as Instagram and TikTok and all the different platforms that you can utilize. But it's also very important that you do the thing that you enjoy combined with the thing that might drive traffic to your channels. So when it comes to YouTube, I will still keep making the videos. I will still keep posting vlogs. I will still do everything in my power to deliver information and entertainment to you in the way that I can and the way that I have up until this point. The personal goals that I have is that until my 33rd birthday, I want to be in way better shape than I am right now. And when I turned 32, which was a couple of weeks ago, I said to myself that that is going to be my goal 1 year from now, to be in a better shape. I don't want to go back to the bodybuilding style physique that I had back then, but I kind of want to have some sort of, you know, fit body that I feel comfortable with, but it's also very funzionale. And one of my long-term goals that I'm setting up for myself right now is going to be economically independent. I don't know when and I don't know how, but I want to be that. And I think that in 10 years from now, it can be possible if I play my cards right. And the cool thing about that is that being able to document my way to that point is gonna be a perfect way to keep a good longevity in this channel. And it's also gonna be a great way for me to be as creative as I want to be whenever I'm making a video. Yeah.